So this is a carbide lamp or lantern. They used to be used on miners' helmets, and it's not a very good idea to have an open flame in a mine, so eventually they stopped doing that because explosions happen. But I also learned just the other day that these used to be used on cars. And
it's a pretty laborious process to actually be able to use these. So I cannot imagine having to use this for the headlights on a car.
But you would go out and you would set it up just like I'm going to do here. So the lantern has two chambers. There's an upper chamber and a lower chamber. The upper chamber is for holding water. And then the water drips slowly through this valve down here, which I can control the flow rate with a little dial here, which changes how open it is and how much water can drip through. And the water drips through down to the bottom chamber where the carbide is. So it's actually calcium carbide that's in there, but the carbide's the important part. And when the calcium carbide and the water react, acetylene gas is produced just like it was in the prior demo there. So we add water to the top chamber. Start it flowing down into the bottom. And that should begin to produce the acetylene gas. In fact, if I pull the bottom chamber off again here, you should be able to see that water is... should be leaking down underneath. It seems that we have a clog though.
There it is.
Oh, there it is. So you can see the water is dripping down underneath, and then because the water is dripping down underneath, then it will react with the calcium carbide that's down there, which will form the acetylene gas, which will then flow out the little hole here. And there's a striker here, but it's old and not working anymore. So I'm going to try to light it. There we go. And we have our little flame there. And that is your the acetylene gas there burning on this. And it should be much brighter than that, but it might be the amount of gas we're generating, or it could just be that the system is clogged a little bit. But it's a fairly white flame. There's some yellow and blue in there. And then this normally would have been much, much shinier. And so then this would reflect that light out. And it's like a headlight on a car. And it was decently bright then for the purpose. I may also not have enough carbide down in the bottom there. But then this is an old miner's lantern. Really basic chemistry. As I said, though, you don't really want to have a... open flame down in the mine, so they eventually stopped using this and started using a Davy lantern instead. But unfortunately, I don't have one of those to show you or how it works. Although it worked kind of similar to how Sarah's demo worked with the pillar of fire or flame tornado. The mesh kept the flammable airs from getting in instead of keeping the flammable air inside from getting out.